The Peter Schiff Show.
I think I broke something.
That was funny, right? I hope Peter doesn't mind me screwing up his office.
But we have huge news today. We got gold news. We got dollar news. And as you know, I haven't treated gold nicely, right, since the top. There's times that we accumulate, and then there's times that we don't. And here, let me draw this for you so you can understand how I trade. So looking at this trade, my lighting's going to be terrible. My camera's like, what are you doing? See, you buy here, and you sell here. I'll show you again. And I'm actually going to steal this out of Meet Kevin's playbook, because I know he does a lot of drawing. But do you see? So we buy here, and we sell at the top, okay? Because this is where the good stuff is. And then it'll come down, and you rebuy, and then it comes back up, and then you enter your next position at the top. Well, actually, you don't want to enter a position at the top. You want to exit your position at the top. So here, let's head over to gold. Okay, so we're on the gold chart right now. Oh, hold on, wrong one. There you go. I found it. Ta-da! Click. Now, there we go. Now we mean business. And I want to show you something. I actually got a whole lot of hate when I was like, hey guys, you may want to start exiting your position. No, bravo. Gold is God's money forever. And I'm like, okay. All right, I'm sorry. Sorry that I said that. And then I actually left this chart up. I probably have had this going on for a while. I didn't clear it. This right here, we have some strong support. Yes, we do. And I did a video on this. This, my friends, is called a double. That's a double bottom, not kind of like this double bottom, right? Yeah, aha. So we had a double bottom on gold. I mean, everything is pointing up. Now Johnny Bravo can get back in, because I don't like buying things up here. I like buying things down there and then selling them when they get up there. And another thing is, we have been in this clear channel all the way down. And now we are exiting said channel. And also, if you get your news, you know, from bobbleheads, this is all confusing. This has probably been very confusing for you over the last year, when everyone and their mother is screaming hyperinflation, buy my gold, but gold keeps going down. Now it's funny, it's gonna like switch. And they're going to go, oh, okay, now there's no, it's just, everything's deflationary, and then gold goes up. But then at the end of the day, because you trade charts, not farts that come out of these people's mouths, you're like, I got this game now. And also one more thing, you will never on this channel see sponsored, right? I never have anyone sponsored on this channel. It's just me. I'm a capitalist. I believe in producing a product, right? A product. And then selling said product. And if learning how to trade this stuff seems interesting to you, right? I have a whole nice product down below. It's a course on how to do all of this. So, and I leave a pretty dramatic discount link. And I don't know, drastic or dramatic, one of the two. Now, getting back to the chart, and let me move it around a little bit, and then I will zoom in. Actually, let me grab a little pointer for you so you can see what I am currently looking at. Here is your, well, this is your 200-day moving average. As you guys know, I prefer to trade things. One of the things that I look for is above that. I want momentum upwards. And as you can see, it just slammed its head right there on it. I have to zoom in and I'll show you. But I wanted to kind of pull back and show you this channel that we're in. And the good news is we are currently out of that channel. So step number one, buy indicator comes on and says, hey, this is trading on the daily. If you go through a course, you get it. This is how I trade. One candle close above the 9. And then up and away it goes. Now, this is where it closed when it jumped out of there. It jumped out of that channel and everyone's like, yeah. So step one, step two, here is step number three. And when we close above that, oh my gosh. But you know what? Let's do this. Let's balance real quick. I want to balance charts with a little bit of news that makes a whole lot of sense. Now, This was actually aired on Real Vision. This was in February. This is where Groman and Ed Harrison, Real Vision, and who Gammon picked up on it. So what I want you guys to see, listen to this clip on where actually gold could go. And we're talking 50,000 if this whole print a coin, you know, make it worth X amount, throw it in the TGA. But listen to these guys.
We did. We're sitting here at 130% now. We were at whatever, 80% back then and going higher. So you need to get the debt to GDP down really fast. And there is a...
Yeah, we're at 130 right now. That needs to come down. Ah, they have a solution, and gold happens to be the answer.
A point in the, or a portion that was pointed out to me in the Federal Reserve Bank operating manual, it says that it's right there in black and white. If the Treasury tells the Fed to revalue the gold higher, the revaluation amount gets put into the Treasury General Account, or TGA. And the TGA, they can spend however they want. It's just an accounting creation. It's gimmicky. It's wonkish. It's no different than Paul Krugman recommending the $1 trillion platinum coin, except with gold, he used platinum, but it's the same damn thing. So the challenge is our debt's so high, you'd have to revaluate gold enormously. It's basically $4,000. Every $4,000 on gold is $1 trillion into the TGA, right? So if you took gold to $50,000 an ounce, as incredible as that sounds, you would be putting $12 trillion, give or take, into the TGA. And then you could stimulate, you could build infrastructure, you could build education, you could do all these things that would take GDP up enormously over the next several years. And at the end of that, not even over the next several years, a year from now, debt to GDP could be 60, 65%. And now the Fed can normalize rates after this de facto significant devaluation of the dollar. And so it's really the only way out at this point, in my view.
Did you catch that? The only way out. Oh my gosh. The only way out is to create a $1 trillion coin, right? That speaks history, you know? They've tried that before, but hey, let's see if the U.S. is like, $20 trillion coin, okay, debt is now paid. But I love what is happening with gold. This is the momentum, right? Momentum trader that I am looking for. Let's get this going. Let's get into this. Gold accelerates to best week in 6 months on dip. Well, see, here it is. This is why, you guys. Did you know why gold went up? It has nothing to do with the charts. It's because of job growth. And you want to know how much money CNBC would lose if they started talking like technicals? Oh my gosh, we were like, sweetie, change the channel, please. These squiggly lines make no sense to me. I'll tell you why. You want to know why gold is booming? You got a double bottom here. Okay, there we go. That's one. We broke out of this channel here. We're going to hit the 200-day moving average, probably bang our head on it for, you know, maybe a couple weeks or something like that. And then we are off to the races. And look at this. See this strong V, gentlemen? Guess what you do with strong Vs? Yeah, you get into them. Or ladies. I don't know. We do have ladies on this channel. I don't want to offend anyone when it comes to getting into those strong Vs. Also, one more thing. This can never ever be financial advice. I don't know what I'm talking about. It is actually guaranteed you will lose 100% of your money if you go buy that little buy symbol and go, oh, you buy there? Okay, that makes sense. That's that's a really strong buy there. And just to cover my esophagus, this is all just paper trade. See, create new order. Okay, you come right down here, you click connect, or I have another way that you don't have to lose money. You go take that 2 free stocks from Webull down below, right? They're giving you money. And then you could use that said money and then you swing trade, right? You just keep it rolling. You win some, you lose some. You win some, you lose some. You just need to win some more than you lose some. And then at the end of the day, Gavin Newsom takes all your money anyways, because that just seemed to rhyme. And Sam Zell buys gold with inflation reminiscent of the 1970s. Remember that, kids? Good old inflation. And I personally, you guys already know my take. I think it is transitory. Oh, I know. But I know that I hate the Fed. Like, just to agree with them is so painful to me, but you cannot take these Chuck E. Cheese, you know, the reserves that they create. if you go down the rabbit holes and you understand where money is created, which it's really not even money, blah, 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 you could kind of figure out the way. I think, although I think you could have short-term inflation. And now the Fed is backed into a wall. They can't, rates can't go up. Oh my gosh, you can't, the debt, trying to pay off the debt with anything higher than zero is going to break the system. But if you want your hyperinflation, I know this story's old, but the Treasury has already minted $2 trillion coins. This was coming to you from good old Paul Krugman. But if you guys want your said hyperinflation, print these things. Go ahead, just do it. Let's get this thing going. Or you take the debt, right? And you monetize it. The Fed just puts it right. You need their balance sheets, put it right into your account. I mean, they're going to do something. Remember back 2008, money printers went burr, money not moving. And let me move myself into some mountains for you. And now money printer go burr again, right? Money not moving. That's all you got. That is all you got. And more stimulus, it's not moving. And the Fed knows, and they're going to have to do something because they're running out of time. Oh, and yesterday I screwed up. I was going to talk to you guys about the slowing housing market. Hey, take a look at this.
Well, Toronto's red-hot housing market stalled last month as home sales and prices declined. That's not something we're used to saying about the country's largest market, which has been on a tear as low rates and the work-from-home trend drive demand. All of a sudden, though, momentum screeched to a halt in April, and the local real estate board chalking it up to early signs of a maxed-out pool of prospective buyers. Let's talk more about that pool of buyers and sellers with longtime Real Estate Watch.
And you're like, but we're not Canada, Bravo. We're America. Yeah. North America? We're all friends. We're connected, brothers. So, hey, guys, be on the lookout. I thought, and can I be totally wrong? I thought the housing market would crash during the lockdowns, and then it explodes. I'm like, oh, missed that call. And then I go and sell my properties. And well, maybe I got this one right. My gut feeling, though, was telling me that this summer was going to be the big blow off top in the housing market. But wrong again. You see, as traders and investors, you get some right, you get some wrong, and then when you have to put it all out on the interwebs, you kind of get called out on it. A joke like this, Doge, 25,000% in 6 months. That missed that one. And we will see, will Elon pump the little puppy? That probably didn't sound too good. And I'll see you on Saturday Night Live or tomorrow.